Welcome to our channel Dentistry to the Point. In this video, we are going to see another malignant tumor, that is your squamous cell carcinoma. Now, this is a very vast topic as given in your Schaeffer's and as per your oral medicine and radiology both. Also, this is a very important long note question frequently asked. So, I have made this video in a very simplified manner to make you understand this and learn it here and here itself. Be with me throughout the video and we learn this topic in minutes. So let's get started. Okay, talking about the introduction, firstly the definition. So the definition which is given according to Pinborg goes as malignant epithelial neoplasm. As we all know, it's malignant in origin, related to epithelial, exhibiting squamous differentiation as characterized by formation of keratin or presence of intercellular bridges. Now this line I am not going to explain you here because this is related to histological feature. The definition is actually a histological definition. So when we'll study the histological features, this statement is going to be automatically clear there. But as you can understand from this, now actually you have known that all these carcinomas are nothing but exophytic growths or mask a growth hota hai. They ulcerate and they grow. So why the growth is there? Because of the keratin, excessive keratin formation as seen in the histological picture and presence of intercellular bridges. The squamous cell carcinoma, the other name for this is epidermoid carcinoma or epithelioma, and it is the most common malignant neoplasm of the oral cavity. Now in the basal cell carcinoma, which is discussed in a separate video, that is the most common malignant neoplasm, okay, which appears on the skin, etc. But this is the most common malignant neoplasm in the oral cavity. So here is the difference and here is the catch. So it is it can be asked as an MCQ question in your competitive NEET PG exam, that the most common malignant neoplasm of oral cavity. So if the answer is squamous cell carcinoma and not basal cell, it is the most common tumor. But for oral cavity region, it is the squamous cell carcinoma. If you have not checked out our basal cell carcinoma video, I'll give the link in the description box and also pop an I button. Moving to the epidemiology as in the distribution of the tumor, ki kaun se countries mein hai, kya prevalence rate hai, sab kuch. So it has high incidence. About the epidemiology or the prevalence rate, so high incidence countries, these are your South Asia countries like your Sri Lanka, India, Pakistan and Bangladesh. The male is to female ratio is obviously 2:1, as we're aware. Whites are more commonly affected as compared to blacks. So the oral cancers are commonly seen in whites. Why? Because jo carcinoma of lip hai, that is more commonly seen in whites. That's why oral cancers are seen in whites more than blacks. 2 to 10 per 1 lakh of population every year is affected. The mortality rate is lowest for the carcinoma of lip, and 80% of the oral cancers are preceded by pre-malignant lesions or conditions. Now these are just the details, actually these are not to be learnt, but yes, if you can remember the facts and write in your exam, you are going to get, you are going to fetch good marks. Also, as the last point says, 80% of the oral cancers are preceded by pre-malignant lesions and conditions. So a separate video is made on this also, pre-malignant, what is a pre-malignant lesion, what is a pre-malignant condition. So please do watch that, for which the link I'll give in the description box and also pop an I button. On to the etiology. So there are various factors which are responsible, firstly of which, or the main cause or the leading cause, is the consumption of tobacco. Now tobacco could be in any form, in the smoke form as in BDs or cigarettes, or in the smokeless form, that is your chewable or inhaled form, in the form of snuffs, dips, or your gutka, paan, which has your betel nuts, everything. So tobacco is the leading cause for this. And also, if this is in combination with excess of alcohol consumption, then it is the leading cause of squamous cell carcinoma. Secondly is the high exposure to ultraviolet radiation, that is your ionizing radiation. So any kind of high exposure could be there, like a person working out in the sun, like farmers, fishermen, etc. Or even if a person is receiving any kind of radiotherapy or radiations for a particular disease, that type of exposure also. Third is role of nutrition. Now it is supposed that diet which has low amount of vitamin A, your C, E, iron, selenium, folate and other trace elements, also inadequate consumption of fruits and vegetables, these cause increased risk of oral cancers. Okay, so next is systemic health or immunosuppressed. Now also systemic health as in includes your any kind of underlying disease which is present, like with advancing age the host mechanism it decreases. Also in cases of diabetes, HIV, renal homograft recipients, etc. So in these cases, these pose a important contributing factor for the development of squamous cell carcinoma. Now role of viruses. Now actually this is unclear and uncertain right away, but then they have said that human papilloma virus, that is HPV virus, has got a close association with the oncogenic genes or the cancer causing genes in the body. So there is a strong connection of carcinoma with human papilloma virus. Now next is your dental factors or trauma. So this is also a sustainable point, or this is also an unclear point now, but then they have said that these factors can be an underlying contributing factors, like your poor oral hygiene, faulty restorations, ill-fitted dentures, sharp teeth, etc. Also the last thing is genetic susceptibility has also been counted as, like gene mutations which are seen on the chromosome 3p 4p 6p and etc. You don't have to remember these, it's just an extra information provided. So yes, any mutations in the gene can also lead to squamous cell carcinoma. So these are all the etiological factors for squamous cell carcinoma. To the clinical features or clinical presentations or signs as you see in your squamous cell carcinoma. So firstly comes your SAC sac, that is your sex, age and common site. So males are more commonly affected than females. The ratio is 2:1. Okay. The second is age, that is older age groups of more than 40 years, that is 50 to 60 years probably. The common sites are your, firstly, the most common site are your tongue. That includes your posterior and lateral borders of the tongue. Then you have your lip, in which the lower lip is more common than the upper lip. Buccal mucosa, floor of the mouth, palate, maxillary sinus, labial mucosa, gums, etc. Okay, all can be involved. But the commonest ones are your tongue, lower lips and buccal mucosa, and these are less common. Also characteristic, or you can see as a beginning, is ulceration with indurated margins. Now actually you're going to come across the ulcer word again and again with its base, indurations, reverted margins. This is going to be more clear when we'll make a video separately on ulcers in general surgery, because that's a separate topic to be dealt in general surgery, where we're going to learn about the margins and the types. So be patient about that. Okay. So actually different sites have got different variations, as in if it involves the tongue, it has something different characters, lip different. So now we are going to see the clinical features for each of them, be it your tongue, your lip, buccal mucosa, floor, one by one. Starting with the clinical features which are responsible for carcinoma of tongue. So actually I have also mentioned the etiology and everything here, but then the etiology and everything remains the same as we have dealt earlier. That is, elderly men are affected. Lower lip is more common than the upper lip. That is, of all the cases, 83.3%, 88.3% of the cases affect the lower lip, 3.3% cases upper lip, and 8.3% cases labial commissures. Then you have the etiology, which is same as tobacco, poor oral hygiene, prolonged exposure, and syphilis obviously is one of the factors. I've told you immune status of the patient and the systemic health. So syphilis is there. Also trauma can be there. Also leukoplakia, which is a less common factor but may be involved. Now we'll see actually what is the clinical presentation when the squamous cell carcinoma invades your lips. Talking about the clinical features of the carcinoma of the lip, so it begins on the vermilion border of the lip on one side of the midline. Okay, so in one half of the midline it begins. Then small areas of thickenings are seen in the starting. The initially small areas of thickenings and indurations, all ulcerations, as I mentioned in the clinical features, that it's going to start with an ulceration with an irregular surface is going to be seen. Then it becomes large, so small crater-like defects are shown, and it shows proliferative growth of the tumor tissue. So nothing but here, as you know, tumor is nothing but a mass. So it's going to grow. Firstly, it's going to ulcerate, be a small lesion, which is going to be asymptomatic. Then it's going to turn into a big lesion or a growth, a mass, axovitic growth, which is going to be painful. It spreads to involve submental or submaxillary lymph nodes. Now actually see, one more thing I have to mention here, that as we're going to see the individual areas or sites which the squamous cell carcinoma affects. So they all have this basic thing in common that it's going to start with an ulcer-like thing which margin specified and irregular, and then it's going to grow. Firstly, it's going to be asymptomatic, then it's going to be painful. So this is going to be a common thing. The difference is going to lie to where does it extend or the lymph nodes it spreads to, of which we are going to see in lastly when we discuss all of them separately. I'm going to give you a chart where you do a comparative study of all of these so that it's you get a better understanding of this. Secondly is the carcinoma of tongue, that is a painless mass or ulcer which is painful when secondarily infected. Okay, initially it's not painful. I've told you this 100 times now, and this is going to come again and again, that initially it's going to be a small ulcer which is not going to be painful. It develops on the lateral and ventral surfaces of the tongue. Now the common sites in the tongue itself are like in the lip, it was the lower lip. In the tongue, it is the lateral and the ventral surfaces, and dorsum surface is rare. Superficially indurated ulcer with raised borders. Then it's fungating or exophytic growth. Exophytic, that is growing outwards from the surface. Okay, so exophytic growth is nothing but when it grows outwards towards the surface rather than invading the tissues, that's an exophytic growth. Then it infiltrates into the deep layers of the tongue, producing a fixation, that is it causes rigidity and it gets fixed to the tongue. And also a patient who develops carcinoma of tongue is going to have a sore throat and dysphagia, that is difficulty in swallowing. Now third is the carcinoma involving the floor of the mouth. So most frequently it is present in the anterior portion of the floor of the mouth. Okay, anterior portion mein hota hai. Indurated ulcer, so same line, indurated ulcer of varying size on one side of the midline. It may take wart like growth which tends to spread. A wart like growth is nothing but a round benign growth pehle banti hai that tends to spread otherwise or metastatize. It may or may not be painful. Referred pain to the ear. Okay, so from the floor of the mouth, it may the pain, the referred, the when the growth occurs in the floor of the mouth, so the pain may be referred to the ear. Also, because of the close proximity with the tongue, it may produce restricted or limited movements of the tongue, which may cause slurring of the speech and excessive production of saliva. Also, since this is in close relation to the anterior tooth, so there may be loosening or mobility of the teeth, resulting in their exfoliation and root resorption. May even extend to the submaxillary and the sublingual glands, because in the floor of the mouth you have your submaxillary and sublingual glands. So definitely metastasis or metaspasis matlab hota hai spread to involve. So it may spread to involve your submaxillary group of lymph nodes because that is the closest to floor of the mouth. Okay, and then is carcinoma of buccal mucosa. The site is most frequently along or inferior to a line opposite to the plane of occlusion. So where there is plane or occlusion, to uske opposite jo line hoga, that is your buccal mucosa area, wahan par ye hoga most common frequent site. It is often painful. It also begins as a small nodule and enlarges to form a wart like growth which ultimately ulcerates and bleeds. Extension into the muscles of the neck, alveolar mucosa and into the bone may occur. Okay, now these buccal mucosa se close hai aapke muscles of the neck, alveolar mucosa, and ultimately bone may occur, and it may also spread to involve the submaxillary lymph nodes. Now there are others also, like as we have discussed of the lips, tongue. Similarly, there is carcinoma involving the palate, your labial mucosa, maxillary sinus, gums, etc. The most important ones we have covered in point wise, but now we are going to see in a tabular form, or we'll do a comparative study so that it's easy for you to learn them. Table showing the comparative clinical features or clinical appearances or clinical presentations in the various sites. So you have your lips, tongue, floor of the mouth, buccal mucosa, labial mucosa and palate. Okay, so you just have to remember these 4 to 5 points and then you're sorted. You if you're able to remember, actually if you're able to remember this, you can also tabulate them in an individual form, like we have just dealt ki lips ka alag se, tongue ka alag se, floor ka alag se. But ye ek tabular form mein aap yaad kar lo, ek table ye itni se yaad rakh lo, to individual features automatically you learn. क्योंकि बेसिक तो आपको पता ही है कि इट्स गोइंग टू अल्सरेट, बिकम स्मॉल, एसिम्प्टोमैटिक, फिर वो बड़ा होगा, पेनफुल होगा, एंड एक्सटेंशन जो है, जो उसके पास के एरियाज है वहां पे वो जाएगा. So the site for lips, you know, like lower lip is more commonly involved. In tongue, you have lateral and ventral borders. In floor of the mouth, that is the anterior part of the mouth. In buccal mucosa, inferior to a line opposite to the plane of occlusion. Labial mucosa, mein, you have lower labial mucosa more commonly involved than the upper one. And palate is the palate. Actually, palate kyun hota hai? Kyunki rog reverse smoking practice follow karte hai. Okay, so that type pe aap palate use karte ho. Ta, matlab, the whole of the palate where there is site of reverse smoking, wo area of the palate is more commonly involved. As I've told, small ulcer usually asymptomatic, then it enlarges and becomes painful, and since it's an ulcer and you'll deal about it, so it's an indurated, everted margins. और बस ये डिफरेंस है कि एक्सोफाइटिक हो सकती है या एंडोफाइटिक ग्रोथ, मतलब किसी की एक्सोफाइटिक ग्रोथ हो सकती है, किसी की एंडोफाइटिक. अब एक्सोफाइटिक का मतलब मैंने आपको पहले भी बताया, इट्स नथिंग बट व्हेन यू सी दैट अ मास इज ग्रोइंग आउटवर्ड्स फ्रॉम द सर्फेस, ठीक है, रादर देन इन्वेडिंग द टिश्यू, इट्स नोन एज एन एक्सोफाइटिक ग्रोथ. जब वो बाहर की तरफ ग्रो कर रहा है, और जब वो अंदर की तरफ ग्रो कर रहा है इन्वेडिंग द टिश्यू, दैट्स एन एंडोफाइटिक ग्रोथ. एक्सो एज इन बाहर के सर्फेस इन्वॉल्व करते हुए, एंडो मतलब विद इन द टिश्यू को इन्वेड करते हुए. ओके, नाउ एक्सटेंड क्या होंगे लिप्स में, तो ठीक है डीपर टिश्यूज ऑफ द लिप्स में जाएगा, टंग में भी डीपर लेयर ऑफ द टंग में जाएगा, फ्लोर ऑफ द माउथ में क्योंकि सब मैक्सिलरी सबलिंगुअल ग्लैंड्स क्लोज प्रॉक्सिमिटी में है तो वहां जाएगा. बक्कल म्यूकोजा में मसल्स ऑफ द नेक, एल्विल म्यूकोजा और बोन क्लोज है तो वहां जाएगा. लेबियल म्यूकोजा में फिर डीप लेयर्स ऑफ लेबियल म्यूकोजा, और पैलेट के पीछे क्योंकि टॉन्सिलर पिलर्स आ जाते हैं, आपके यूविला आ जाता है, इवन सॉफ्ट पैलेट को इन्वॉल्व कर सकता है, ओरोफेरिंग्स को, नेजल कैविटी को, तो ये सब पैलेट के एक्सटेंशन है. टॉकिंग अबाउट द मेटास्टेसिस, दैट इज व्हेन इट स्प्रेड्स टू इन्वॉल्व द लिम्फ नोड्स. सो अगर लिप्स में कार्सिनोमा है तो इट्स गोइंग टू इन्वॉल्व योर सब मेंटल एंड सब मैक्सिलरी लिम्फ नोड्स. टंग में है तो सुपरफिशियल एंड डीप सर्वाइकल लिम्फ नोड्स. फ्लोर ऑफ द माउथ में है तो सब मैक्सिलरी लिम्फ नोड्स. बक्कल म्यूकोजा में है तो सब मैक्सिलरी लिम्फ नोड्स. लेबियल म्यूकोजा में नॉट सच इन्वॉल्वमेंट, या इतना कॉमनली इन्वॉल्व नहीं होता, यहाँ पे फ्रीक्वेंटली इन्वॉल्व होता है इसलिए, और पैलेटल में भी नहीं है. सो दिस इज अ टैबुलेटेड वर्जन ऑफ द क्लिनिकल फीचर्स. बेसिक याद करोगे तो एक्स्ट्रा ऐड करके भी इंडिविजुअल जब एक एक को डील करके लिखोगे तो यू कैन राइट.